certainly were persuasive to me, Robin. What a touching topic. Thank you for doing that very much. So next, we have the person who confided in me that he's stuck on doing his final speech for the AC Broads, and so he's going to do, he told me, not his first, not his second, not his third, not his fourth, but his fifth icebreaker.
This year I helped teach religious ed at St. Peter's on the north side of Columbus. My son's in seventh grade. I've taught other years, and our religious ed year just finished a few weeks ago, and the organizer, Maureen Lewis, who is in charge of not just 7th and 8th, the middle school group, but also 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th, she invited us out to a Mexican restaurant to thank us for volunteering. And I like food, and it also fit in my schedule. Now, a couple years ago, I taught 4th grade, but I'm not with that group anymore. They meet Wednesday after school. The middle schoolers are different, they're older, they're more mature. They meet on Monday evenings. So I'm going to this Mexican restaurant, thinking in my brain, there's gonna be about 20, 25 people there. There's 6 grades. It's Albuquerque on the north side. I walk in. I was probably figuring that I was one of the last to arrive, and I asked, hey, is there a group for St. Peter's? They pointed me to a back room, and I walked in, and I came to a room a lot like this, as far as size. And there were 2 diagonal tables, sort of close to each other, right in the middle of the room. As a matter of fact, if you sat on the inside of one of the tables, you'd be back to back with people on the inside of the other table. It was that close, very intimate, kind of what I expected. And one table, I knew pretty much everybody at that table. Even Father Summers, our pastor, was there. Maureen Lewis was there, her aide, Teresa, a few of the teachers, Stephanie Speed, who I worked with this year. She was a fellow 7th grade teacher. The other table, I didn't know anybody at it, and maybe because of Toastmasters, I instinctively sat down at the table where I didn't know anybody. Because I thought, you know, we ought to mix in, not just always sit with the people you know. And so I waved to Stephanie and Maureen and a few other people, and I sat down at this other table. And I looked around and I thought, man, I wonder what grades they teach. It's kind of weird. And there were a couple kids, and I thought at first that was a little odd, but you know, if you can't find a sitter, Maureen certainly would love having the kids along too. And then something hit me. And I looked back at Stephanie, and she's looking at me going, like this death nod, like, oh my God. And then I realized, this table is not our group at all. That table over there was St. Peter's. This is like, and as it turned out, a family gathered for St. Peter's, for St. Patrick's celebration, for a dinner. And they actually all were wearing green. And the kids were, you know, in the family. Everybody was in the family except me. And at that moment, I kind of chuckled to myself, and I thought, oh, that's another resplendent moment you've gotten yourself into. And yet, this is actually normal for me. And it used to frustrate me, but actually, I just kind of chuckle now, because it's yet one more social situation I completely misread. All through my life, I sometimes struggled to fit in. I didn't have a lot of friends. I often wanted to be by myself. I'd walk home from middle school. I only lived a few blocks away. Most of the kids in my grade would walk down one side of the street. I'd be parallel to them by myself, walking down the other side of the street. I didn't think anything of it. It probably looked a little odd, but it suited me just fine. I've managed throughout my life, but only when my oldest son, Connor, who's 15, struggled to fit in, struggled in school, Janet and I started to dive in and made note of quirky behavior, odd social situations, all these things. We even had him sit down with a counselor when he seemed to be depressed. We were a little concerned. And then when we made this little list, we realized it all described me also. Whether you call it Asperger's, somewhere on the autism spectrum, the names hardly matter sometime. I finally discovered that, yeah, I guess I'm kind of quirky, and I guess maybe I fit in those categories somehow too. Toastmasters has been an amazing arrow in my quiver as I've managed through life. Because it's not easy. There are some things we're really good at, And then there are some things we're not good at, and being comfortable with the gap between those two things, it's so incredibly important if you can get comfortable with that gap. Some people cannot, some people can't handle it. They never want to approach things they're not good at. And 11 years ago when I got involved in Toastmasters, I entered a whole world that I was not comfortable with. I thought I was just joining Toastmasters because I wanted to be comfortable in front of a room of people. And that certainly happened. And I get more comfortable each and every time. But I now realize some of my quirks and my issues relating with people are just something we all deal with, some more than others. When I talk with you one-on-one, I often don't give you enough eye contact. I apologize, but it's painful. Often I'll completely misread a social situation, but I don't get frustrated now, I just kind of chuckle. And people who know me, and the people in that room, a few people have known me pretty well, they just kind of shook their head and chuckled. But Toastmasters has benefited me in many ways, because when I was sitting at that wrong table, it was sort of like a table topic. Everybody was immediately tense, immediately a little concerned because I did something so stupid. But I stood up and I immediately, without missing a beat, said, you know, I don't think that St. Peter's group is going to be all that fun, so I was hoping to do this. You know what? I'm going to give them a try, but I might be back. And everybody laughed, and they all said, we'll make a chair for you. And everyone was at ease, and I sat down, and I thought, oh, brother. And we just chuckled about it, right? Without Toastmasters, I probably would have been real tense, and I probably would have just kind of crawled over to the other table, and everybody would have stayed tense. But you know, life isn't easy, but if we can find a way to relate with people better and interact with people better and learn more about ourselves better, life is much more fun and interesting. And I'm glad to be a part of this organization and a part of this club.
Absolutely resplendent. Welcome, come in.
Thank you.
Absolutely resplendent. And that is, whether John intended it or not, he actually showed a great deal of vulnerability. He really did. I really mean that sincerely. He shared a lot about himself. So thank you, John, for that resplendent piece of action. Now, we move next to speaking spontaneously. There's not a person in this room that has not in working.